Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a new listing of mine here in San Diego, California. This is Soulmates, a 2009 Hunter 50 center cockpit. Now this is a rare vessel here for the West Coast. There's only a couple of them out here, and let me show you the features and benefits that make this vessel really stand out amongst its competition. We're here at the bow of the vessel, and the Hunter 50 center cockpit is world renowned for the 49, but the 50 is the same hull, just a different layout, configuration, different cabin top, and this 50 offshore center cockpit is pretty impressive. It's a Glenn Henderson hull design, full carbon fiber from the bow section all the way to the forward part of the keel. Hull to deck joints are all through bolted every 8 inches, and again, the vessel is built very, very well. As we move our way back to the transom of the vessel, one thing you're gonna notice, we have two entries, both to starboard and port, a small storage locker here. There is a dedicated life raft locker built in underneath this bench seat right here. We have a hot and cold swim step shower, water inlet, shore power, TV, phone, and the list just goes on. As we move our way up, you're gonna see we have storage lockers and propane access, both to starboard and port. And again, a really nice fluid walk around vessel, all the sheets and halyards leading into the cockpit. We have two electric general winches and electric cabin top winch. Dodger and connector here from the forward part of the arch to the Dodger itself, a full Dodger cover, keeping that isinglass really nice. Beautiful wraparound windshield here. And you're gonna see when we go down below just how much natural light that really floods in. Self-tacking inner stay cell. There is a forward cushion up here with those tracks. And then we have a sail locker just forward of this inner self-tacker. So nice little sail locker here. We have our windlass locker that's separated as well too by inner glass bulkhead there. And again, looking aft, you can see just what this really possesses. Double swept-back spreaders, radar with a Riley stainless steel mount. And again, all the sheets and halyards leading back into the cockpit. Nice wide side decks here, inner shrouds. All of this is bonded down to the keel bolts as well. And again, just a really nice, fluid, easy boat to walk around and really just enjoy all of its outdoor space. Here on the back section where I had talked about that dedicated life raft locker or a storage bin here, we have a large bench seat cup holders, both starboard and port side. A nice seating bench here with backrest that even has bolstering. And then as we move into the cockpit, you can see by having the Lumar folded wheel, it really gives you the space you need to get around this nice large cockpit for a center cockpit. It's pretty impressive. And again, I talked about the electric winches. We have a VHF RAM mic, a Raymarine autopilot, multi-repeaters, our bow thruster controller here, and this is a full engine digital readout as well too, showing your RPMs, our temperatures, and everything we need to know about the engine right here. Just above this is our E80 GPS chart plotter with the integrated radar into it. Moving forward, we have this beautiful Corian cockpit table that folds up, so giving you a cockpit table and this nice space that you need, and then when it's not in use, stows away. Cabin top, starboard winch, multi-repeaters up here, and our cockpit stereo controllers. One thing I really like is this companionway door slides down out of place here, so there's no lifting and pulling that out. But let's go down below. We have the galley off to the starboard side. The galley is really impressive. We have Corian countertops, stainless steel grab handles here. The refrigerator is a full refrigerator, freezer. And then we also have a top loading freezer as well too. So this could be used as fridge or freezer, but again, great use of space. Lots of storage and little cabinet space there. We have a tap-in microwave, built-in coffee maker, our Bose surround sound speakers, three burner stove and oven with overhead exhaust vent. But again, look at the attention to detail and how they've done with the just the cabinets. It really sets this off. It really makes it a nice galley feel. Double stainless steel sinks, and again, lots of storage and drawer space around too. There's actually a little bin here, so you can house and use, you know, as far as additional storage. Our companionway ladders that will unpin, get out of the way if so desired. And then directly across from us is the nav station. The nav station is set up quite nicely with our generator controllers here, our tank indication gauges, masterator switches, our charger inverter, our 12 volt 110 panel, our VHF, this is a Raymarine smart controller, and our E120 GPS plotter. And again, there's additional, you know, storage and cabinet space behind this, and all of our main breakers are located down below. So again, really nice seat here. Directly behind that is a large pantry storage room. As you can see, large use of space. You can put a washer and dryer down here if you so desire, but a great use of space. I'm gonna take you to the aft master first. And as we walk our way back, engine room access is down through here. Generator access is through here. Just a couple little push of the buttons and that will open up. But we have our head and shower compartment. This is a Japsco Quiet Flush electric toilets. Really nice separate area here. Lots of storage around. And then a full walk-in shower. It does have the smoked glass doors here that encompass that shower compartment. But again, as we make our way back aft, this is one impressive aft stateroom. So if you're looking for an offshore cruiser or a great liveaboard or just a great vessel to spend some time on and really enjoy the ocean, this is something to take a serious look at. Heating, air conditioning controls throughout, lighting, access into our aft side of the engine. You can see we have a Samsung television here and a full walk-in closet. Again, really impressive. I mean, you have bins here for all of your clothes. We have storage here. This door closes. We have another chest of drawers right down below here. Bench seat off to starboard and port side. Look at the, I mean, opening hatches are just really impressive on this boat, letting a lot of natural light in and ventilation. Underneath the bed is a full jacuzzi, and or as you can see it, how this owner uses it as a storage bin. But a great use of space. That was an option from the first couple 50s that Hunter Marine produced. And again, it's a good storage spot, or you can use it as a jacuzzi. Stereo CD DVD player here, nice lounge seat, and forward facing vanity mirror there. Again, as we walk back through the vessel, you can see this beautiful interior woodworking, how it transitions into the galley floor there. And look at the headroom. I mean, an insane amount of headroom here in this vessel. I would say it's at least 7 foot. And again, just a beautiful, nice open feel. Very similar to the 49, but obviously with extended headroom, and that master aft cabin is just impressive. Large salon table here. This could be dropped down and turned into additional berth. Again, we have the Bose surround sound speaker, Sony flat screen television, large bench seat off to the port side here. As we move our way back aft, forward, we have air conditioning heating controls there, Sirius controller, and this is our Bose stereo CD DVD player. But again, great use of space, really nice leather upholstery, and again, these overhead windows just really just let in that natural light and feels like you're not down below in a cave, which I really love. As we walk into the VIP cabin, we have a separate shower stall here to the port side. Large V-berth up here. Hanging locker, tons of storage around. And again, we have air conditioning, heating, ventilation up here. But just a nice use of space. A little vanity on this side. And then our head compartment off to the starboard. Japsco Quiet Flush electric toilet. And again, nice little vanity, great use of space. Behind this door is a hanging locker closet with additional storage throughout. There's also lots of storage underneath all of the seating as well. I mean, there's just one thing about this boat it doesn't lack is storage, headroom, and amazing volume with great sailing characteristics. Well, I know that was a lot of boats to take in a short period of time, but please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs. Thank you again.